So welcome, Dr. Banks.
Just in time. So welcome, and for those of you who don't know me, I have been a counselor for 24 years and I have a private practice here in Georgetown. I graduated with my master's degree in counseling from Texas State University and then went on to the University of Texas to gain another master's degree in program evaluation and then a PhD in developmental psychology, social psychology, and personality psychology. I am a licensed counselor and I am not a licensed psychologist. About 2 years ago, I had probably the most stressful professional year of my career. I looked at my stress that year to determine exactly where it was coming from, and I found that the majority of it was coming from these very severe alienation cases that I was working on. I needed to find a way to continue doing the work or I was going to have to stop doing the work, which many of the mental health professionals who work in this area end up doing. And it is the reason why we only have a handful who are willing to take on these cases. So I felt some loyalty to these families as well as to my community of legal professionals and colleagues and mental health professionals to decipher what it was about these cases that were so difficult to work on, beyond that, the obvious, and to see what variables I could do something about. One variable that I identified was that I was working with mental health professionals and legal professionals who really wanted to help, but who didn't have an in-depth knowledge of parental alienation. And so while I was trying to make changes in the case and what I felt like were efforts to try and save a family and save a child who was in danger, I felt like I was swimming upstream oftentimes, having to educate the very people that I needed to help me assess the case, contain the case, and treat it. They were all very good professionals and all wanted to help, but the availability of education on this topic was not easily accessible. So I made a commitment to myself to begin educating on this topic and decided that anyone who asked me to speak, I would speak, despite the fact that I do not consider myself a profound public speaker, and to do this sort of thing causes me a great deal of anxiety that probably affects my my family for weeks in advance. But I did decide that if I had been able to withstand cross-examination on the witness stand for 15 years and summon up the courage to do that, because you guys are tough sometimes, I could come up with the courage to put together a presentation about something that I deeply cared about and provide some education to help the most innocent of our community and our children. So to that end, I appreciate and am full of gratitude for you allowing me to present this information to you today. I took all the information that I had and continue to learn on parental alienation and found that it really fell out into these four main categories. What is it and how does it happen? The second category, the assessment protocols to determine what's going on. The third category, the treatment options for the families. And the fourth, the importance of the intersection of legal professionals, the judiciary, and mental health professionals. Each of these segments are probably about an hour long talk, so clearly we will not get through them all today. We will get through section one and hopefully be able to talk about a few key parts of 2, 3, and 4 and answer some questions. And hopefully I can intrigue you enough to perhaps invite me back for part 2 or 3. I also want to say that I am dedicated to spreading this information, and if you have a group of legal professionals that you would like to get together over an informal session of lunch, I am happy to come to your office and provide another training session on another part of this presentation. Okay.